So if you look at the redo log, it has a transaction header, and in between the transaction header and the end mark are all the changes that have been made in that particular critical section by the developer. And for each of the address range within that critical section, what is the new data that corresponds to the changes that have been made to that range? Similarly, what is the new data for this range, new data for this range? That's the structure of this redo log record that has been created and forced to the disk. Now, when we resume from the crash, what we need to do is make sure that the external data segments are updated with all the changes that have been made and recorded in the redo log, but have not yet been applied to the external data segments. So crash recovery is, of course, the whole reason for LRVM. And what we're going to do when we resume from crash is read the redo log starting from the tail of the entire log segment. And that's where the reverse displacements come into play. And once you've read the log from the disk, apply it to the external data segments where it has to go to. All of that information is contained in the redo log record in terms of the transaction, what is the address range that is being modified, what is the external data segment that particular address range corresponds to. All that information is contained in the redo log record. So we can take that and apply it to the external data segment. And once you have done that, you can throw away the log. So that's how crash recovery works.